this is great.
Yeah.
Listening to drama character, pair work hobe, even with actor. তারপর আমরা বলে রাখছি আমার কিছু রিকোয়েস্ট আসছিল নেক্সট নেক্সট ফ্রাইডেতে একটা ওয়ার্কশপ করার সেমিনার করার সিভি রাইটিং নিয়ে সেটা মনে হয় একটু হ্যাকটিক হয়ে যাবে তাই না তাদের মিডটার্মের আগে সেটা হতেও পারে নাও হতে পারে আমার শিওর বলে সেটা যেদিনই হোক মিডটার্মের পরে হোক আগে হোক সকাল 9টা থেকেই হবে আদারওয়াইজ এটা হবে না বিকজ ফ্রাইডে ছাড়া দেখা যায় ম্যাক্সিমাম স্টুডেন্টস আসে না ফ্রাইডেতেই হবে It will be made mandatory for all of you. Because it's a not that I say about it. Say, Friday,
it's
in
me class.
How many good? I mean, students see that I regularly not the chest should provide a college to provide me. Seminar or rock art. Yeah, rock art required a seminar version of লেন্থি সেশন আমি বললাম, হ্যাঁ, তো এই কদিন আমি চেয়েছিলাম মিড টার্ম পর্যন্ত স্লো যেতে, বাট না, আমাদের একটু ঢিলা দিয়ে আস্তে আস্তে যেতে হবে, সো দ্যাট আই ক্যান রিচ এভরিওয়ান। প্লেটা পড়ি, আপনারা যে ওয়ার্ডটা শুনবেন সেই ওয়ার্ডটা লিখবেন, যদি দুইটা থাকে কনফিউশন আপনি দুইটাই লিখবেন, পরে ইউ ক্যান রিমুভ।
Before I invite you to join in a discussion in this second part of the seminar, I'd like to make some very important points about our fieldwork, and in fact, any field trip to look at rock art. We're going to a number of sites, and we won't always be together. The single largest problem faced by people who manage the sites is, yes, I'm sure you guess, damage caused by visitors, even though it's usually unintentional. Whenever you do go to a site, don't forget, you can learn many things from observing at a distance, instead of walking all over it. This can really help to reduce visitor pressure. People often say, well, there's only two of us, and just this one time. But many thousands of people are saying the same thing. And then, some basic rules to guide you. We'll have our own camp near a village, but remember never to camp on a site if you go on your own. It may be disrespectful to the people of that culture, and certainly don't make fires, however romantic it may seem. It's really dangerous in dry areas, and you can easily burn priceless undiscovered material by doing so. So, how are we going to enjoy the rock and art on our field trip? By looking at it, drawing it, and photographing it. Never by touching it or even tracing it. Rock art is fragile and precious. Remember that climbing on rocks and in caves can destroy in a moment what has lasted for centuries. So no heroics in Namibia, please. Try to be extra careful and help others to be too. Oh, and lastly, please don't even move rocks or branches to take photographs. You should leave the site intact. I'm sure I can rely on you to do that. Well, that's about all I want to say before today's first discussion.
Engravings show footprints of animals and
না করেন তাহলে হবে না, শুনার পেছনে কথা বলছেন, একজন আপনি তাকাচ্ছেন, ডিসকাস করছেন, ইন দ্যাট সেন্স করতে করতে কিন্তু বাকি ল্যাগগুলো কিন্তু চলে যাচ্ছে, বুঝতে পারছেন? প্লিজ ডোন্ট টক, রাইটিং স্পেশালি কিন্তু এই কথাগুলো বলি না যে কথা বলেন না, কন্টিনিউসলি কথা বলছেন আপনারা দুজন, কথা বলে কি লাভ? যদি কথা বলে তাহলে তো আপনার কথার উপরে ব্রেইনটা কাজ করছে, আপনি কিন্তু শোনার থেকে সরে গেলেন, ঠিক আছে, করতে পারে না either one of them, okay?
Cats in the engravings seem to be half-human. Some, for example, have got human faces. Many researchers now think that these were pictures the wise men engraved of themselves. They believe they could use magic to control the animals they had drawn, so the hunters could then catch them for food. This shows you some of the dangers of coming from one culture to another, as we'll be doing, without understanding it fully. Scholars imagined that children looked at rock art pictures to learn to track, just because they themselves had learned skills from pictures. Many researchers now believe that rock art had a much more complex purpose, and we'll talk more about it next week. Now, before I invite you to join in a discussion in this second part of the seminar, I'd like to make some very important points about our fieldwork, and in fact, any field trip to look at rock art. We're going to a number of sites, and we won't always be together. The single largest problem faced by people who manage the sites is, yes, I'm sure you guess, damage caused by visitors, even though it's usually unintentional. Whenever you do go to a site, don't forget you can learn many things from observing at a distance, instead of walking all over it. This can really help to reduce visitor pressure. People often say, well, there's only two of us, and just this one time. But many thousands of people are saying the same thing. And then, some basic rules to guide you. We'll have our own camp near a village, but remember never to camp on a site if you go on your own. It may be disrespectful to the people of that culture, and certainly don't make fires, however romantic it may seem. It's really dangerous in dry areas, and you can easily burn priceless undiscovered material by doing so. So, how are we going to enjoy the rock art on our field trip? By looking at it, drawing it, and photographing it. Never by touching it or even tracing it. Rock art is fragile and precious. Remember that climbing on rocks and in caves can destroy in a moment what has lasted for centuries. So, no heroics in Namibia, please. Try to be extra careful and help others to be too. Oh, and lastly, please don't even move rocks or branches to take photographs. You should leave the site intact. I'm sure I can rely on you to do that. Well, that's about all I want to say before today.
Okay, so, 4 minutes from now, I've got a boro boro shash
tracks in here we confuse that.
Very much confused.
So talking about using the tracks for animals. In here you stop it. When you play again, we lost it where it was.
Okay. It was my fault. Okay, anything else you find difficult? Actually, discuss for it though, you will miss for it. So, common sense, that is apply for it. Sometimes, in the common sense, they fill in the ones for it. Listen in child, if you miss that lesson.
Is it Cambridge Isles or something different?
It's Cambridge Isles 7. 7 means it's like from the year.
Yeah.
Maybe 2015?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
14 maybe.
Yeah. So the latest ones are like revised and even more tricky. And this one is like pretty easy. So did you do IELTS?
Yes. So first time 2019 it was 5.5.
Okay.
The second one in Istanbul it was a 6. It's 2020 almost or 2020.
It appeared in us from Uzbekistan or from Bangladesh?
Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistan.
I did it.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is the first seminar in preparation for our archaeological fieldwork in Namibia. We are fantastically lucky to have received partial research funding for this trip from our institute. So I should expect 200% attention and participation from you all. First in this seminar, I'm going to give a brief introduction to contemporary research on rock art. And in the second part, I'm going to give you some do's and don'ts for our fieldwork trip in April, so please listen very carefully. I'm first going to focus on the interpretation of rock art in Namibia. We are very fortunate to be going to an area where you can find some of the most important sites in the entire world, and I hope to show you how easy it is for everyone to make mistakes in looking at cultures which are different from our own, the first and most important lesson we have to learn. In Namibia, there are both paintings and engravings. That's where the surface of the rock is cut out. Many of the engravings show footprints of animals, and most scholars used to think that the purpose of these was simple and obvious. This rock art was like a schoolbook with pictures to teach children about tracks, which track belonged to which animal, giraffe, lion, and so on. But there were some mysteries. First, when you look at a typical Namibian painting or engraving, you see the tracks are repeated. There are dozens of tracks for the same animal. Well, you'd expect just one clear illustration if the reason, the aim was to teach tracking. Now, there were two more problems. Why are some of the engravings faces. Many researchers now think that these were pictures the wise men engraved of themselves. They believe they could use magic to control the animals they had drawn, so the hunters could then catch them for food. This shows you some of the dangers of coming from one culture to another, as we'll be doing, without understanding it fully. Scholars imagine that children looked at rock art pictures to learn to track, just because they themselves had learned skills from pictures. Many researchers now believe that rock art had a much more complex purpose, and we'll talk more about it next week. Now, before I invite you to join in the discussion in this second part of the seminar, I'd like to make some very important points about our fieldwork, and in fact, any field trip to look at rock art. We're going to a number of sites, and we won't always be together. The single largest problem faced by people who manage the sites is, yes, I'm sure you guessed, damage caused by visitors, even though it's usually unintentional. Whenever you do go to a site, don't forget you can learn many things from observing at a distance, instead of walking all over it. This can really help to reduce visitor pressure. People often say, well, there's only two of us, and just this one time. But maybe thousands of people are saying the same thing. And then, some basic rules to guide you. We'll have our own camp near a village, but remember never to camp on a site if you go on your own. It may be disrespectful to the people of that culture, and certainly don't make fires, however romantic it may seem. It's really dangerous in dry areas, and you can easily burn priceless undiscovered material by doing so. So, how are we going to enjoy the rock art on our field trip? By looking at it, drawing it, and photographing it. Never by touching it or even tracing it. Rock art is fragile and precious. Remember that climbing on rocks and in caves can destroy in a moment what has lasted for centuries. So, no heroics in the middle, please. Try to be extra careful and help others to be too. Oh, and lastly, please don't even move rocks or branches to take photographs. You should leave the site intact. I'm sure I can rely on you to do that. Well, that's about all I want to say before today's first discussion. But if you have any questions, please ask them.
Did you get all correct?
I have one question. The first answer, he's talking about tiny world. Like, tiny world. Like, when we write the world, we should put the tiny, but when we put the tiny, we should leave the world. Which one comes more comfortable? Like, we should put together tiny world, right? For the first answer.
The first answer?
Yeah.
Preparation for future to know the
action. Yes.
That's not time.
It's archaeological.
He was talking about a time when they were going to.
So like
what would the answer?
Archaeological is like the subject
yeah,
of the archaeological
rock. For the first question answer. What was it?
It's the time. It's archaeological.
No, it's not archaeological. The answer is time?
No. He was talking about the time. When they were going to
31. What did you write?
April.
It's April,
right? Yeah. Make
all
the
two children. Any other answers? Children and?
Animals.
People, animals?
Scholars.
Scholars?
No, I got that. They were using it to help animals.
So is the correct answer is children. Look at the sentence, which part is missing? We're talking about a few things. Which part are missing? J part are missing. Chaitanya Prabhu, it's too tricky. 3?
Unit 3 is repeated.
Repetitive. What else?
Mysterious.
Mysterious.
Mysterious. What have you written?
Solitary.
Sorry?
It's unrealistic.
Not really. It's repeated. It's repeated. What was the listening character?
5.5. Jabel, আমার বন্ধু সে ঠিক আছে আমি শুনেন আমার কাম
That's enough to communicate because we could understand what you are talking about. So, like that, you also need to have a basic understanding of English so that at least you can communicate or give the message to your listener what you're trying to talk about. At least give the message. Otherwise, communication will break down. So here are some examples of a so-called okay paragraph, sort of good paragraph, but these are not argumentative paragraphs. In your exam, there will be argumentative paragraphs like I did in the last class. And here, you just can take a look at number one. I'll talk about these. So example of a somehow well-written paragraph. I won't say it's an example of good paragraph. And you can photocopy from, because I have limited copies. Also, I have these things posted in my group. You know the basic English group? You can share, by the way. I have limited number of copies. Do you have a cafeteria over here?
Yes.
Okay, so is it like, can I go there and get some food now, for example? No?
No.
Why?
It's closed. These days, the food service is not working.
Why is it closed? Why do you think it's closed?
Because you don't go there and buy food. You think it's expensive? Am
no.
I right?
No. It's the reason because of after first semester, the students stopped to come to university. In this case, the cafeteria, the food shop have to close.
Okay.
I think soon they will run their business again.
The cafeteria basically made a few losses.
So why don't you like put an application in a very nice wrapper to action to return direct? They can't can action to the channel, they will need a cafeteria. Sit and chat because you need a place to gather and talk about yourself.
Yes.
So look at this example paragraph.
Mark it with your pen. The first sentence is called the first sentence which summarizes the entire paragraph. What is it called?
Topic
sentence.
Student center?
The first sentence, okay, that is the title. Look at the first sentence. Eating in the student center is a pleasant experience. Tarmane, this means the entire paragraph will talk about how it is a pleasant experience in the cafeteria. Er bare kichu bolbe na, er age piche, there won't be anything else. It will be only talking about how pleasant or why it is pleasant to eat in the cafeteria. After the cost of a chair, do you feel bad? You can say, okay. So I'll take a pause, maybe I'll give a break and then start. Okay, so just after the topic sentence, directly going into the reasons. So first reason is what?
Food is excellent.
The food is excellent. So when you say the food is excellent, you just can't stop there. Say I love this class. So I'll say, if I say I love taking language classes with the BBA people, and I can't stop there, I have to explain why, how they are different from the others. Okay, so maybe I'll have to give an example, good example. Because what? Because these people are attentive, they seem to be responsive, while the others don't. That's why I love taking classes with the BBA. So the first reason is, first the food is excellent. Look at the next sentence that is an example of the first reason. It is well prepared, it tastes delicious, and there are many different kinds of food. So you see, that person is just not saying that the food is excellent. That person is saying that Kano excellent. Why it is excellent? Because it's well prepared. It's delicious. Yes, so you please mark it. This part is the example of the sentence. Mark it. Okay. Next reason. Where's the next reason? The next reason starts from moreover. Moreover, each person serves his or herself, selecting just what he or she wants. Okay, so this is also part of the example. Sorry, this is not the reason. Yes, the second starts from the student, comma, the environment in the student center is positive. So this is another reason for the claim. Claim ta ki chilo? What was the claim?
Pleasant experience.
The environment.
Pleasant experience. So pleasant experience kano bolo. Seta ke justify korar second reason holo the environment in the student center is positive. Tar kache environment ta bhalo lagche. Shudhu khabar ta bhalo lage ni. Ekhon she dicche example. Look at the example. Many happy young people are talking and laughing. However, the atmosphere is still calm. That means eto chilla chilla palapi poreo khub halko hotable na khub chaotic na. It's not that chaotic. It's possible to study and do homework. So
ইয়াং পিপলরা হাসছে, কথা বলছে, টিজ করছে, মক করছে, আবার তারা ওখানে পড়ালেখাও করছে. দিস ইজ অ্যানাদার রিজন. ইভেন দে আর দ্য স্ট্রেঞ্জার্স ইন হাই অ্যান্ড অফার টু শেয়ার দেয়ার টেবলস. ওকে, সো আমার মনে হয় থার্ড রিজনটা, হ্যাঁ they will talk to me, and then they will not be annoyed if you ask them a question several times, right? So third reason, take to apara, you can change the third reason because it is student lekha ekta paragraph. So yes, so three reasons won't be connected to each other. Think a tin rokomer reason hobe. And the last reason is staffs are friendly. These people are really polite. They will give you more food if you ask for it. For example, amader cafeteria te, when I used to get some food, I used to ask the mama to beshi kore den, and he used to really put more. Okay. So you can give specific examples. So have ami dekhala apnake personal experience dile sobcheye bhalo marks paben. So who just came in? Ke eshe chhabe last. Acha, so ekta peyeche apnara, peyeche apnader kache ache. So this was an example from a book tag. Any question? Anything you want to share? Any question? No question. You people are all clear, right?
Yes.
তাহলে পরীক্ষার আগে আমাকে ইমেল দিবেন না? পরীক্ষার আগে আপনি রাতেবেলা বলবেন না, হাই ম্যাম. How can you do that? আপনি কি করে চেষ্টা করেন?
Old.
এটা সবচেয়ে লেস ইম্পর্টেন্ট একটা হ্যান্ড আউট আমি আপনি বলে রাখলাম তো আপনারা না বুঝলে হয়তো দুই মাস এর বেশি না এটা লেস ইম্পর্টেন্ট বিকজ এখান থেকে আমি কম মার্কসের কোশ্চেন করি টাইপস অফ প্যারাগ্রাফ এখানে কোনোটাতে আর্গুমেন্টেটিভ প্যারাগ্রাফের কথা লেখা নেই ঠিক আছে যেটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি আমি আপনাদেরকে মিড টার্মে লিখতে দিব সেটা হবে যদি মিড টার্ম আপনাদের হবে না বলে তো নাই I'll give an assignment on that. Write an argument in paragraph. Okay? Okay. Why? Why do you want to attend the midterm exam?
To get good grades.
Good grades. So, are you sure? That means you're sure that you're attend for the good grades, Pavan? কেন আপনারা শিওর যে অ্যাটেন্ড করলে গুড গ্রেডস পাবেন হাউ ডু ইউ নো দ্যাট
হাউ ডু ইউ নো হোয়াট
হাউ ডু ইউ নো দ্যাট ইউ উইল গেট আ গুড গ্রেড ওয়েন ইউ অ্যাটেন্ড দ্য এক্সাম লাইক ইভেন বিফোর অ্যাটেন্ডিং দ্য এক্সাম ইউ নো দ্যাট ইউ উইল গেট আ গুড গ্রেড হাউ কাম ইউ আর সো কনফিডেন্ট
উই আস্ক ফ্রম অল
দ্যাটস নট আ গুড অ্যানসার
প্রিপেয়ারিং প্রিপেয়ারিং লাইক According to exam topic, we will prepare ourselves.
That's so nice. That is like way too good, huh? Is that your reality? Or you know that the teachers will give you marks no matter what?
Say no.
Okay, so types of parents to chole action. আমি হয়তো একটা প্যারাগ্রাফ আল গিভ অ্যান প্যারাগ্রাফ অন ইউর মিড টার্ম অ্যান্ড আই উইল আস্ক যে এটা কী রকমের প্যারাগ্রাফ জাস্ট টাইপটা লিখে দিবেন হোয়াট টাইপ অফ প্যারাগ্রাফ ইজ দিস ইউ জাস্ট রাইট দ্য নেম অফ দ্য প্যারাগ্রাফ অ্যান্ড ইউ গেট টু মার্কস ফর ইট ওকে ফর এক্সাম্পল দেয়ার মাইট বি আ কোয়েশ্চেন লাইক দিস প্রথমটা দেখেন ডেসক্রিপটিভ প্যারাগ্রাফ What is a descriptive paragraph? Any idea?
So we can
describe about things.
Describe about anything,
things,
materials,
people.
People. Yes.
Anything.
What is described here?
Old car.
It's about an old car.
It describes about the old car.
And the writer's emotion,
right?
I don't want to read it entirely. The old car slowly chugged down the street like the cabins of a steam engine train. So it's all his feelings. Old carta এখনো loyal আছে তার প্রতি এখনো চলে অনেক বয়স হয়ে গেছে তারপর এটা is giving a service whether although it's very old and worn out. The interior was dusty brown with holes covering almost every square inch of the seat covers. So it's a pretty old car. This old car is my old car. When you say like this is emotion. You can't bring emotion in the yes. So this old car is my old car. It's as faithful as a good old dog, right? As by always turning and getting me from where I need to go. So cook simple. When you see anything being described in a paragraph, that is a descriptive paragraph. Nothing more to know. Okay? The next one is narrative paragraph. Would you like to read?
Like storytelling.
So do one thing, write the sentence. Start reading from here. Do the sentence for your read for it. So read out two sentences and then pass to the next person. I want to hear everyone reading. Shuni Aparati reading korte pare. এখন আপনার টেনশনে পড়ে যেন না হ্যাঁ আমার উচ্চারণ ঠিক মতো হয় না ঠিক আছে এভাবে করে কিন্তু শিখতে পারেননি হ্যাঁ বিকজ ইউ নেভার অ্যাটেন্ডেড আমি কথা বলবো না আমি খারাপ ইংলিশ বলি স্টার্ট ইট কে শুরু করবে হু ওয়ান্টস টু স্টার্ট মিস
মাই ফেভারিট ফ্যামিলি এক্সপেরিয়েন্স One of my favorite family experiences was when I went to see Anne Frank, a Jewish victim of the Nazi persecution during World War II, hired out in Amsterdam, Holland. I had read Anne's published diary when I was younger. So I was extremely thrilled to actually have the chance to see what she and her family did from the Germans for so many months.
Okay, thank you. Next.
I walked up the stairs of an apartment building and into a room with only a bookshelf. From what I remember from reading the diary, there was a doorknob behind the books. I found the doorknob and turned it, and there was a secret annex. When I stepped into the room behind the bookshelf, I felt as if I had stepped back into history.
Okay, next. Come on, three. Can you read?
Yeah. I found enemies. Mostly pictures of our favorite celebrities or our ones. The friend family's furniture was still placed where they had left them in the rooms. Everything just as described in the diary.
Okay, next. Loudly.
I toured each room in awe of actually seeing how they had lived. Yet with sadness to know how it all ended. Anne's diary was no longer just a book to me, but a true heartfelt emotional life story written by a girl I felt I almost knew.
Okay, thank you. So, what is the meaning of
tour?
T-O-U-R? What is the meaning of the word tour?
Touring.
So if I want to, yes, you're right. Because it comes from the word tour. So the actual native pronunciation is tour. Grammatically tour boli is tour. So it means, you know, visiting the place, you know, roaming around.
Tour.
So why is it called narrative paragraph? What do you think?
It's telling about the
experience sharing.
Experience.
I. So it's narrative. It's very easy. But give a paragraph of what to say. I do that. Then you know that it's narrative. The next paragraph. Who wants to read?
First, you want to start the water and about 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil boiling for the noodles. They take the longest. And then, while you have that cooling, start dicing your chicken breast into about 1 inch cubes.
So, you know what is dicing?
Yeah, it's
cutting.
Maybe after a word, even if you don't know the word, if you look at the sentence, you know what does this mean. Dicing, what is talking about? Next,
who wants to read? Okay, the last
person,
Zakir Farmashi Bushar
Hashan. Can you read?
You don't
know where to start. After you get, you start from there.
After you get home in 15.
Okay,
with you
stop.
Yeah,
you.
Oh,
start
on
very
first
and then
one.
So,
you
know,
the
easy.
to love the modern?
Ingredients are added to the heat. Heat will get turned on once your frying pan is in hot water and
more.
Butter into the pan, pan, fry pan, let that melt a little bit and then add your chicken.
Okay, thank you. Now, who wants to you on the first plate?
You want to make sure that the chicken is browned and all slides and and if you were cut up a cup in half that the middle is white. Anytime while you were cooking your chicken, if the water boiling, then you can start boiling your noodles. So when your chicken is done all the way thought, then we make the sauce.
Okay, next, who wants to read? You.
Right there in the same pan that you cook the chicken in, add your 2 cans of cream of mushroom soup and your 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. After dumping the soup in the pan, you will need 2 cans the amount of milk that you put in the sauce.
Okay, now the last 2 lines came from that. Okay, now there is a lot on the other side. Let's not read more. Technically, key bullshit. What is it about? How do you make the process better?
It's a process of making a chicken, cooking a chicken.
It's a sort of manual, right? Yeah. I think it's the easiest to see text when you do that.
It's more
like
a
instruction how to do it. And then the classification parameter, for example, gives us to just add in various types of spoons. Okay? So how many schools are there, types of schools, what do they provide, you know?
Public schools.
Basically. So Durapur University has a private and public. This is all about classification. I think it's a pretty easy thing to study. So our half an hour jeta hobe. আপনারা একটা প্যারাগ্রাফ লিখতে অ্যাটেন্ড করতে চান নাকি আপনারা একটা গান শুনতে চান? গান শোনাতে ইচ্ছে মনে করেছেন? লিরিক্স বলতে হবে, গান শুনলে লিরিক্সটা বলতে হবে। Recorded it to the bottom and you so that I can sing a song. But Gan Shunano